Hello and welcome to Stern Effects. This video is all about preview modes and viewer quality preferences in After Effects. So After Effects provides several options for previewing that makes various trade-offs between speed and fidelity. In this tutorial, I'll show you everything you need to know about the layer and the viewer quality. So let's get started. To demonstrate the different quality modes, I'm going to use this project, which was created by my friend Ido Katsiri from Dodo Motion. And you can learn more about Ido's wonderful work at dodomotion.com. The link is also in the description below. Now, this project was created for the A+ channel during the pandemic, and it was aimed towards kids to help raise the awareness of COVID and how to protect from it. If you want to see it with sound, wait until the end. But for now, I'm going to stop the preview and also purge the cache by going to the Edit menu and using Purge All Memory. Notice there is a keyboard shortcut that I'm going to use. Here on the Mac, you've got two options: Option Command and forward slash, or Control Clear. Both of them are located on the numpad. I'm going to do it from time to time, so we can start fresh. I'm also going to go to the Composition menu, and under Preview, turn off cache frames when idle, so After Effects won't try to cache those frames in the background. Now we are ready to see the first options that controls the quality, and these are the Comp Viewer controls, and you can find them under this pop-up menu. So right now it is set to auto, but you can change it to full, half, third, quarter, or even create a custom quality. Now notice that you can control this from these options, or you can go to the view options, and under resolution, you have few keyboard shortcuts that may be worth memorizing. For example, Command or Control J is going to always show you the full quality. Add the shift modifier, and you will get to half. Third doesn't get a keyboard shortcut for some reason, but quarter is all the modifiers. So here on the Mac, it's Command Option Shift J. On the Windows side, it will be Control Shift Alt and J. So this means that if I'll press Command Shift J, I can change the quality to half, which you may or may not be able to see. So to demonstrate it, I'm going to zoom into the viewer by pressing the period key. And you can obviously now tell that we are seeing half res. If I'll switch to a quarter by pressing Command Shift Option J, this will be Control Shift Alt J on the Windows side. You can see how this works. Now, if I'll change it back to auto, and then I'm going to zoom out or in, this time by pressing the period key, this is zoom out, you can see that After Effects is going to change the quality of the viewer automatically depending on how far away or close I am to the composition. And of course, you can always use the magnification ratio pop-up to change from different kinds of scale depending on your needs, as well as fit it to the viewer. All right. So these are the first thing. I'm going to recommend to set it to auto, which is going to yield the best results in most cases. The next bunch of options are the fast preview ones. And these options are also affecting the comp viewer and will allow you to make various trade-offs between speed and fidelity. Now, the way to approach them is using this little lightning arrow. So first I'm going to actually visit the fast previews preferences, and you can go to there directly from this menu. So here you can set the adaptive resolution limit. I recommend to change it to a quarter. This is going to give you a clearer view and not really trade off so much quality. You can also visit the GPU information. I'm going to return to it in another movie where I'm going to talk about Draft 3D. And I'm going to say okay. And now to demonstrate how this works, I'm going to return to this menu and show you that we have few options. The first one is off, meaning final quality. And this is not going to use the adaptive resolution that we just defined. It means that if I'm going to move my current time indicator, After Effects is always going to try to preview it in full quality. This may slow down your performance, but depending on what you are trying to do and of course your hardware configuration, you might want to use this feature. Again, I'm going to clear the cache and I'm going to switch to adaptive resolution. And notice the difference now when I'm going to move my playhead. After Effects is going to reduce the resolution, this time to a quarter. It will try to keep up with you no matter how fast or slow you are scrubbing the timeline. And this can be really helpful when you're trying to preview compositions that have lots of layers. Underneath, we have another option, which is the wireframe. Now, wireframe is only going to work if you're scrubbing the timeline. It's not going to work if you're going to press spacebar or preview in any other way. And I'm going to show you how to work around this problem in a moment. But for now, I just want to call your attention to the fact that you have few keyboard shortcuts if you want to toggle between those different modes. So again, I'll clear the cache and I'm going to press Command Option 1. This will be Control Alt 1 on Windows and it will set the fast preview to off. Just to verify, I'm just going to show you. Here it is. It is set to off. If I want to switch to adaptive resolution, it's going to be Command Option 2 here on the Mac, Control Alt 2 on Windows, and now we are back to adaptive resolution. In the past, there was also another keyboard shortcut, Command Option 3 for draft, as well as Control Alt 3 on Windows, but I think this doesn't work anymore because the draft mode is not available in the modern versions of After Effects. But if you're using an earlier version, you can give it a try. So I'm going to skip to Command Option 4, which is going to turn on Draft 3D, and of course, Control Alt 4 on Windows. Again, I'm going to clear the cache and show you that if I'll press spacebar, After Effects is going to preview the composition without caching the frames. So this means it is actually using your graphic card, your GPU. If I'll press spacebar again to pause the playback, you can see we are not building cache files. So this can be a very good way to preview stuff, even if you are not using 3D. Now, there are a couple of other advantages, such as the ground plane, as well as the extended viewer, and I'm going to talk about them in the next tutorial. So for now, I'm just going to switch them off and show you that there is a keyboard shortcut to go to the wireframe mode, which is Command Option 5 here on the Mac, Control Alt 5 on Windows. And again, the limitation here is that it only works when we are scrubbing the timeline. If you do want access to this feature while you are previewing everything, I'm going to show you how to achieve it now. So first, I'll press Command Option 1 to return to the final quality fast preview mode. And then I'll select a few layers here on the timeline. I'll click on this one, I'll scroll up, and I'll shift click, let's say, over here. Now I can go to the Layer menu, and under Quality, I have few options. By default, it will be set to best, but we can change it to draft and wireframe, as well as change the scale algorithm from bilinear to bicubic. And of course, you've got keyboard shortcuts for everything. So the letter U plus Command, Command Shift, or Command Shift and Alt. And this, of course, is going to be Control, Control Shift, Control Shift and Alt on the Windows side. So let's see how this works. I'm going to change it from best to draft, and you may or may not be able to see it. So again, I'm going to zoom in. This is draft. I'm going to press now Command U to change it back to best. And you can see that basically we are changing the quality. And by the way, you can do it from the timeline. So if I'll click on this swatch over here to change it from best to draft, you need to click it twice because the first time you click it, it will change the scale algorithm. And this can be helpful if you are scaling layers beyond 100%. So give it a try. I'm going to click it again to change it to draft. So this is draft and this is best. But I can't use this switch to turn it to wireframe. If I want to switch those layers to wireframe, I can go back to the layer menu and then under quality, select wireframe, or I can memorize the keyboard shortcut. And now we can see that it will work even, and I'm going to zoom out, when I'm going to press spacebar to preview this composition. And this can be very helpful if you have plenty of layers. I'm going to select everything here and convert all the layers in this composition to wireframe by pressing Command, Shift, Option, U. And on the PC side, it will be Control, Alt, Shift, U. And now I just want to show you, if I'm going to continue playing this, that everything is going to be wireframe. And for some reason, I'm not sure if this is a feature or a bug, this is going to affect all the open compositions that you have here. So you can see that these comps are showing us also wireframes. And these wireframes look a little bit different because the quality switch for the composition is set to quarter. So if I want, I can press Command J to switch it to full res for both of these. So let's make sure that everything is set to full resolution. And now if I'm going to preview it, we can get a sense of how this works. So you need to be mindful. Again, I'm not sure if this is by design or a bug. It's really a nice way to take a look at a very complex setup and check that the timing and the animation works, because wireframe will always play in real time. All right, I'm going to select all the layers over here and then press Command or Control U to bring everything to its best quality. And now I can also turn on the audio and maximize the viewer and play it once again, but this time with audio.
Take care of yourself and others. Wash your hands often. Keep a sufficient distance from others. Cough into your elbow. Stay home if you are not feeling well. A+ kids, grow smart.
And this concludes this tutorial about quality preferences in After Effects. Of course, this is not the end of the line. And if you haven't seen the other parts in this series, make sure to do so to get the best and fastest experience when working with After Effects. Also, make sure to like and subscribe this video so we can meet again in the next parts, which you don't want to miss.